Just weeks after the passing of music legend Prince, the news came out that he died of an accidental opioid overdose. And it's a problem that affects thousands each and every year. So here to shed some light on this topic are Peter Letender, CEO and Director of Clinical Services of Rhode Island, along with clinicians Tammy and Joanne. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning,
gentlemen.
Thank you. Good morning.
Now, Peter, I hate to say that this is, you know, kind of old news, but this is something that has been around for a while, yet has come to light once again, unfortunately, due to Prince's circumstance.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, we do see this a lot, and there's been a lot of deaths in Rhode Island, as many people know. Mm-hmm. But what we see a lot of now is families coming in looking for answers. How do I help my loved one? How can I intervene? Because I see them spiraling out of control.
Yeah, and Tim, for you, as a clinician, I mean, you are, of course, seeing this firsthand. And I'm sure it can be tough, especially for these families coming to you for possibly the first time.
Yes, it is. What we do a lot of times is we ask them to come to our family group and we provide them with education and knowledge mm-hmm. as to what to do, provide them with options and the way to intervene and be able to incite them with the knowledge of the addiction and recovery.
Benjamin, you've seen some positive outcomes as well.
Absolutely. I mean, once they learn how to self-care, how to take care of themselves in the process, mm-hmm. How to set some, you know, boundaries around helping the individual, setting up a plan to get that individual the right course of treatment, yeah, we've seen some pretty significant changes in people's lives. It's pretty awesome to sit back and be a part of that journey and that process.
Yeah. On the flip side, though, is that enabling that gets that person to that point? You know, so what is enabling, Peter?
Well, enabling, a lot of folks, when they hear the word enabling, they think, oh, they're doing something really significant to contribute to the problem.
Right.
But sometimes
maybe
enabling,
giving them
right.
the drugs.
Maybe
or
giving them the drugs or money. But sometimes
mm-hmm.
enabling can be something just as continuing to let people in your home when they continue to use drugs, or knowing that they might come in your home to steal, but you still allow them to come in the home. Mm. I mean, enabling is a big issue. I mean, Joanne, you could speak to that, I think.
Absolutely. I mean, once again, it's just really educating the person on setting up boundaries, whether it be, you know, invisible boundaries, rigid boundaries, all different types of boundaries, so the person can really take care of themselves in
yeah.
that process, because it's a family disease, and so every single member of that family is afflicted by the addiction alone, and they come in thinking that I don't have this problem, this is not my problem,
right.
and they leave thanking us because they're well equipped with how to handle it.
Like you said, even something like enabling, you might not know that you're doing it.
Right.
Exactly.
Joanne mentioned boundaries, and one of the things that we try to emphasize with people is that There are ways that people can support people who are when they're in recovery, mm-hmm. and that's what we try to teach, as opposed to
a way to do that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, we can teach them some coping mechanisms for the family, but we can also find ways to help them support their loved one.
That's wonderful. You guys are doing some great work. Thank you all so much for
coming in
and shedding a little bit more light on that. If you'd like more information on how you can get in touch with the folks over at Clinical Services of Rhode Island, you know where to go, roadshow.com.